Dear students, welcome to the lecture series on basic electronics. I am Rohit Mathur, assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering at Manipal University, Jaipur. In this video lecture, we would be analyzing clipper circuits comprising of ideal diodes. By the end of this video lecture, you should be able to analyze a given clipper circuit and determine its output wave shape. Before we move further, let us first review key learnings from our previous lecture. Clippers are the circuits that remove the peak portion of the given input waveform. Clippers are basically wave shaping circuits that find use as amplitude limiters in radar applications and other consumer electronics. Now, clippers can be classified in three different ways. First, which peak of the input waveform it clips off makes the division as positive clipper or negative clipper. Second, how the diode is connected in the circuit. Is it connected in series or parallel to the given input? Makes the division as series or shunt clipper. Third, is there any DC source present to bias the diode? If there is, it makes the circuit as biased clipper. If not, it makes it as unbiased clipper. You must understand very clearly what is meant by D on and D off conditions with reference to an ideal diode. When an ideal diode is said to be in the on state, it means that the voltage at the P side is more than that at the N side, thereby making VD equal to 0 volt and makes ID equal to the current flowing through the branch of the circuit that comprises diode. Also, the resistance offered by an ideal diode in the on state is 0 ohm. And therefore, diode can be represented as short-circuited element and is said to be conducting. On the other hand, in the off state of the diode, VD is equal to the potential difference present across P and N sides of the diode, and no current flows through it. Diode is said to offer an infinite resistance. Therefore, diode can be represented as an open circuited element, and it does not conduct. Now, pause the video and try to answer the following questions within 2 minutes. Answer to all the questions in the previous slide was true. If you were able to answer all the questions with right answers, congratulations. If not, I suggest that you listen to the previous lecture again. Our analysis of the clipper circuit is based on three assumptions. First, the ohmic value of the current limiting resistor is negligible. Second, diode D is an ideal diode with cut-in voltage of 0 volt and resistance of 0 ohms. Third, the magnitude of the maximum peak voltage of input signal Vm is more than that of the bias voltage V used in the circuit. We would follow a sequence of 8 steps to get the final output wave shape. First, divide the page into 2 regions and label them as D on and D off regions. Second, find the input voltage range for which diode conducts and write it under D on side. Then, find the input voltage range for which diode does not conduct and write the range under D off side. Third, redraw the circuit with diode being replaced with its equivalent circuit in D on and D off side respectively. Fourth, write the output KVL for these 2 circuits. Fifth, redraw the input waveform with dashed lines instead of solid line. Sixth, mark the decision making voltage on the graph. Seventh, mark D on and D off regions with reference to the decision making voltage. 8th, as per the two KVLs pertaining to D on and D off regions obtained in step 4, draw the final output wave shape with solid line. Let us revise the sequence of steps. First, divide the page, then find the condition, then redraw the circuits, then write the respective KVLs, then redraw the input waveform, then mark the decision making voltage on the graph, then with reference to decision making voltage, mark D on and D off regions on the graph, and finally draw the output wave shape based on the KVLs of step 4 with solid line. Let us take a sample question. In this question, we are asked to predict the wave shape of the output signal. Let us follow the sequence of 8 steps and obtain the result. Step 1. We divide the page in two sides and label them as D on and D off. Then, we find the condition when the diode is on and when the diode is off. We can see that the P side of the diode is connected to negative terminal of the DC source. And so, for the diode to conduct, the input voltage at N side must be less than minus V volts. And for diode to be in off state, input at N side must be greater than minus V volts. Therefore, our decision making voltage is minus V volts. Let us now draw the equivalent circuit pertaining to D on and D off sides. As you can see, under on condition, diode is represented as closed switch, and under off condition, diode is represented as open switch. Now, try to write output side KVL by yourself for D on and D off conditions. As you can see from the equivalent circuit, the output voltage under D on condition would be equal to minus V volts. And for the off condition, it would be equal to the input voltage. Next, we draw the input waveform as it is, but instead of a solid line, we use dashes. Next, we mark decision making voltage on the graph. In our case, it is minus V volts. Then we mark D on and D off regions on the graph with arrows. Then, as per our KVLs pertaining to the two regions, we draw the output waveform . In our case, for D off region, output follows the input. Therefore, the D off region curve is highlighted with red color. In the D on region, we can see as long as the input voltage is between minus Vm and minus V, the output is constant at minus V volts. Therefore, this straight line. And again, for D off region, the output follows the input, therefore this region. Now, finally, this red curve shows the output wave shape, which is the desired solution. Here is a practice question for you. You need to predict the output wave shape for the given circuit and the given input waveform. The references used for making this video are: first, Electronic Devices and Circuit Theory, 10th edition by R.L. Bosted and L. Neselsky of Pearson Education. Second book was Electronic Devices and Circuits, 2nd edition by B.P. Singh and R. Singh of Pearson Education. The images of the circuits that you saw in this video were taken as it is from teaching resource presentations provided with Electronic Devices and Circuit Theory. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed the video. Happy learning.